I like them all. I like the fact that they are shorter, speedier, easy, but still pretty looks. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. I keep saying that. I don't know why. Anyway, today, 5 looks with the Carroty Come As You Are palette. Here she is. Let me show you the inside as well. That's this. She gorgeous. The review is up. I will link it. So yeah, I did 5 looks. I went row by row like this. They are all pretty fast and easy looks. Pretty simple as well, because for, I don't know, for me, this palette just lends itself a little bit more towards fast, grungy looks. That is me personally. So that is what I did in the video. The look that I have is the last look. The makeup that I used will be down below. There will also be timestamps down below for all the different looks. And yeah, you know, I don't know if I have a favorite this time. I like them all. I like the fact that they are shorter, speedier, easy, but still pretty looks. So yeah, if you have a favorite, let me know down below. Let me know if you have the palette. If there are maybe color combinations that I haven't done yet that you would like me to. I am planning on doing a few more palette bingos with this palette as well, to make a little bit more complicated looks like I did in my first impression, that I will also link. But yeah, that was basically my intro. Have a lot of fun watching and I will see you at the ending. So the first look with the Come As You Are palette, and I'm kind of playing with the lighting of my camera a bit and the white balance. So it looks a little bit blue in my viewfinder, but we will see how it looks when I edit the video. The first row is this one. So yeah, what I want in these looks are actually quite simple looks. And then I will do some palette bingos with it like I did in my first impression. And then kind of make them more complicated. That's what I wanted to say. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the color Gwen, which is this one. And that is going to go as my transition shade. I'm tapping it on because I haven't set my base. I actually want to keep the shadow quite low. A bit more pigment in my outer corner. And when I want to keep the shadow low, I actually tilt my head back a bit. Then where I can see that natural shadow, that's where I place it. So it's lower. And then I just actually follow the light in. Now I'm building up the color to the intensity that I wanted. I'm taking a tiny bit of the color at a time to place it and to blend out the edge. Shadow works beautifully, by the way. Are they even? They're even-ish. Okay, I also want this color underneath my eye. I don't want to be too precise about it, so yeah. And I like it when the color wraps around. If you do not, you don't have to. Of course. First color down. I'm going to go with a flat brush in the color What's Up, this one. And that is basically going to go all over my lid with the exception of the inner third. Let's see what it does dry. Okay, not too shabby. I am going to spray. Let's see what it does then. This one is a little bit more harder pressed in the pan. Don't get a lot of fallout. And I don't see a huge difference between dry and wet. I also want this underneath my eye, close to the lash line. And I want it connected here on the outer corner. I'm taking a smaller brush and the color Gwen, which is that matte. It's going to go in the outer corner a little bit, on top of the shimmery green. And then blend out the edge a bit and pull it into the crease. Smaller flat brush and the color called, is it Ugh or Ugh? I don't know. And that one is going to go where I have no shadow. Not that difficult. I've sprayed it. And because it is a bit more crumbly in the pan. And I'm pulling it around my tear duct. Like so. Let's just blend everything together a bit. And that's the eye look so far. I'm going to finish off the look with a liner, mascara, and I will be right back. Everything I use will be down in the description box, so hold on tight. So here is the completed look with falsies and a lippy. I like it. The falsies I ended up wearing are the the 3D Glams in style L12 that I got from AliExpress. The lipstick is the other one from Carity, one of the mattes in the color whatever. And I think that the look turned out really, really nicely. It was a quick and easy look. And yeah, I like how it turned out. Let me know what you think of it down below, and let's get ready for the second look. Look number two. And here is look number two. It's this row. So yeah, I'm going to start with the color Riot, because that is what I'm going to use to set my entire eyelid before I'm going to go in with the green. That's basically my plan. So I haven't set my eyeshadow primer, and I'm going to do that now. And it's going underneath my eye as well. Now I'm just building up the color a little bit to get it to be nice. I'm switching brushes, still in the color Riot, which is the yellow. Just going to place a bit of color here, a little bit in the high crease. Cleaning my brush, I'm going to go into the color Dunk, which is this one. I'm going to place that lower than the yellow, basically. So I'm looking down, tilting my head back, so I can know where I need to place it. I don't want it too high. I'm just going to stamp it on. Yes. And I want to keep it quite close to my eye. Now I'm dipping into the color Dunk again to blend out the edge a tiny bit. Okay, going back in the color Riot, which is the yellow, and blend the edge even more. I'm going to go to the first brush I used without any product, and I'm going to blend the two together. Okay, smaller brush into the color Dunk, which is the green, and I'm going to intensify the outer corner and the crease. I'm constantly dipping back in the pen and placing shadow. Now I'm going to blend it forward, pull it into the crease, taking a tiny bit if I need it. Dipping into the color Riot, the yellow. That green I want underneath my eye as well. I'm taking the color Riot again, the yellow, to smudge out the green on my lower lash line. Let's blend everything together with a very soft, fluffy brush. And we only have a peachy color left, so I am taking a flat brush. It's flat but still fluffy. I'm going to go on the color Live, which is this one. And that's going to go on my eyelid where I have no shadow yet. Just going to press that on, basically. I'm placing it first. I'll blend it out in a minute. Okay, so I placed it, and now I'm going to blend the edge. Not too high. Yes, I want it underneath my eye a bit as well, but I'm using the tip of the bristles. I'm taking a little bit of that color Live, that peachy color, on a fluffy brush to blend out the edge a tiny bit here. Not too much. I want a tiny bit. I do want an inner corner highlight, and I'm going to take the color Drew for that. I could use my face highlighter, but this is a very pretty highlighter as well. So I'm using this this one to cheat a little bit. I could get my BH Cosmetics palette, but okay. And here is the eye look so far. I'm going to finish it off liner, mascara, and then I will be right back to show you the result just before my falsies. So hold on tight. So mascara liner is on. For liner I used a gel pot, and I kind of smoked it out a little bit. And I also put it underneath a little bit in my inner rim, because I didn't want it to be too heavy, but I still wanted that kind of grungy dark look, you know? So this is the, what do I have there? I don't know. The eye look so far. What I'm going to do is put on my falsies, choose a lippy, and then I will be back to show you the finished look. So hold on tight. Don't go anywhere. Here is the finished look. The lippy I paired it with is one of NYX, in turned up in the color Feline. And I wanted a darker brownish lip, but this is more of a brownish red that I actually thought went really nicely with the look. The falsies I ended up choosing are from AliExpress, the 3D Glams in the style 03, but they are a bit weird. So here's the pack. You can see what they look like. They are a bit, well, weird and fluffy because the last pair of this style that I had was a little bit shorter. But anyway, I like the way it turned out. Let me know down below what you think of the look, and let's get ready for look number 3. Look number 3 is the middle row. Let's see what we can build, shall we? So I am going to start with the color Seattle on a fluffy brush. I'm just going to stamp it on. I want to keep the shades actually quite close. And I love the fact that this palette gives you the opportunity to just, you know, create very simple looks like I'm doing in these 5 looks video with just using 3 shades. But you can also do more complicated looks like I did in my first impression with more shades. I really like that. Let's see how deep we can get this shade. Probably not too deep because it is quite light. I can get a little bit of definition in here. I actually want to keep this look quite light today with kind of a twist instead of deepening it up with that orangey shade. Next, I'm going to grab the shade Cool Beans, which is this one. It's going to go on my bottom lid first. Let's just put it all over the lid, basically. And in the low crease. Let's get nice and messy about it. Because today, I feel like it's going to be a messy day. Okay, let's get the first brush. It's clean, or at least it doesn't have any extra. I'm getting a little bit of the color Seattle again. Okay, one color left. Let's just be messy with that as well. So I'm taking my finger, I'm just putting it in the center. And then tapping it a little bit, like so. I think that's fun. So I'm actually kind of creating a halo spotlight-y eye, I don't know. Okay. I want this underneath my eye as well. I'm taking a flattish brush for that, so I can control it a bit better. And I'm going to put it close to my lash line. I do, however, want to kind of cheat. Of course I do. I'm going to get the color Bogus, because I do want a tiny bit of something here in the outer corner. I could do it with my eyeliner as well, but that's it. Okay. Inner corner highlight, let's just get my face highlight, which is from MUA, Strobe and Glow Highlight Kit. It's a very pretty highlighter. I'm very happy with it, so yeah. It's just a subtle. Cool. For eyeliner, the Maybelline Lasting Drama Gel Eyeliner in black. For mascara, the Glam & Doll from Catrice. For falsies, the 3D Glams in style 08. And for lipstick, the L'Oreal Rouge Edition or something like that in the color I Empower. And this completes the look. I think it turned out really, really cute. The falsies I ended up choosing are a little bit softer, and I thought that the look really could use a little bit of a softer falsie. The lippy could have been a little bit darker, maybe a little bit more orangey, but no, I actually like how it turned out. Let me know down below how you like this look, and let's get ready for look number 4. So look number 4, and it is, yes, yeah, it's this row. And I'm not particularly good at dark smoky eyes, but let's try it anyway. So I'm actually going to start with a small brush. This is the Morphe M507 and the color called Duh. And yeah, let's place it first. I think low. Oh Lord. Okay. I'm going to take my time with this because I'm actually terrible at dark smoky eyes. I'm actually stopping halfway. Okay. Now I think I need to blend. So let's see if I can do it with this brush. I cleaned it and then I'm going to just concentrate on the edge without a lot of pressure. Yeah, I thought so. I'm taking a little bit of the color Psych, which is this one. And I'm actually going to see if I can use this to blend out the black. I need to place it first because I haven't set my base, which is probably not a really good idea. It is what it is. So I'm also tapping this in, or actually placing this shadow Psych in. I have a little bit of stuff to blend on. It's probably going to take a minute. I want a different brush. So I'm changing brushes. I have here the Morphe M562, which is small and fluffy. I'm going to use that with the color Psych to blend out that black. I'm doing circles, but I'm not concentrating on one spot. I'm moving the brush because if I concentrate too much on one spot, it will probably get patchy. A little bit of the color Duh, which is that black, to pull it a tiny bit higher. That's what I mean with I'm going to slowly build up the color. Okay, changing to a bigger brush and the color Psych, that yellow. I'm just placing it a little bit higher. Taking a little bit of the color Duh, that dark, and placing it in the lower crease. And I'm actually going back and forth between the color Psych and Duh to, well, basically blend them together and get the gradient that I'm looking for. Now it is time to kind of blend the lid a little bit. So I'm doing circles a tiny bit because I want it a little bit softer before I place the color Psych on my lid. I'm just pressing it on and then kind of blend it. Yes. So I'm going to attempt the same on the other eye. That's going to be so much fun. I do have to say that this dark color blends out really, really nicely. Just make sure that you blend out either with another shadow or on top of a set base, because that just makes it easier. And it's not really a black. It seems to be a very, very dark green, actually. Okay. I'm taking the color Psych because I want to place it here. And underneath as well. I'm cleaning my Morphe, what is it? 506, this one. I'm taking the color Duh and I'm placing it on my bottom lashes. Close to the lash line, but I don't mind it if it is a bit smudgy and smoky and that kind of thing. I'm going to go into the color Psych, which is that yellow. I'm going to place that a little bit underneath. I have one color left, which is called Drew, and it is pretty sheer. That is why I actually lay down some shadows first, because I want to lay it on top. First, I'm kind of pressing it or tapping it on top of that yellow shade. And I'm actually going to go in the yellow and then in the shimmer. So one side shimmer, one side yellow. So I'm kind of combining the two shades. And then I'm going to pull it on top of that darker shade. Okay, I'm taking a fluffy brush to blend it a bit more. I think that's cute. I also wanted a tiny bit more in the inner corner, but for that I'm taking my finger. So let's see what happens when I spray it, because I'm actually curious. Yes, now it is nice and foiled and shiny and sparkly. So if you use it dry, it's sheer. If you use it sprayed, it's nice and foiled. Nice and glittery, silvery goodness. Here I have the Essence Long Lasting Eye Pencil in Go Green. The Maybelline Lasting Drama Gel Eyeliner. My Catrice Glam & Doll in Waterproof. For falsies, the 3D Glam in Style 08. To finish off the look, Color Rouge lipstick from L'Oreal, I think, in the color I Stand. Here is the finished look. I like it. I feel pretty. I like how the look turned out. Let me know down below if you like it too. And let's get ready for the last look. So the last look with the Carity palette. And the last row is this one. Where are we? Here. Yes, go. That one. And it is a pretty dark look today. I did swatch them and you can see them here. This one is a very pretty green-brown duochrome. That one is going to go on my lid. I'm going to blend it out with this and then I'm going to plop the pink somewhere. Because, yes, I know it is the obvious choice to do, but today I'm kind of feeling the obvious. So, yeah. So, I am going to start with the color Bogus, which is that dark brown matte. I'm going to use that as a transition shade, but I'm going to build it up. Maybe I will pull in another color. I'm not sure yet. I'm going to start quite low in the crease. I'm just going to tap it on. And then when I feel I can blend, I blend. I'm just blending out the edge with whatever is left on my brush. Okay, let's darken up the crease a little bit. So I'm getting a smaller brush in the same color. I'm just going to darken up the outer corner and the crease. This almost seems like a grayish brown. It's very pretty. I also want this color down. So, now that we have a nice grungy halo around the eye, I am going to take the color Tattletale on a flat brush, and that's going to go on my eyelid, but I'm going to leave the middle third or something open. It is a bit crumbly. Let's see what it does dry, but I think I need to spray just to help against any fallout. I'm going to pull it into the crease a tiny bit as well, but I am leaving a part open there. Let's see what it does when I spray it for the other eye. And it, when you spray this shimmer, I can feel it sticking to my eye, which is good. Especially for shimmer, so I'm going to do that again, here. And what I'm doing is I'm going to pull it into the outer corner and then down. Close to the lash line. Halfway, there, yeah. I'm taking the previous brush without any product. I'm going to blend the edge a bit. Yeah, I want a little bit of that color Bogus back, that brown matte. Just above the shimmer. And a little bit more underneath my eye as well. Let's take the first brush I used without any extra product to kind of blend out the edge a little bit more. Done. Okay, one color left, which is the color Deja Vu, which is this one. And that is going to go where I have no shadows on the inner part of my eye. This one is also a bit crumbly, so I've sprayed it. And I'm also going to kind of mix it on top of the previous shimmer. And then when I get to the edge, I'm going to wiggle back and forth a bit to mix them together. Yes. Okay, it's also going underneath my eye. And I'm actually going to put it in the inner corner. I am, however, missing a tiny bit of extra sparkle. So I'm going to get the color Drew, which is this one. It's right next to it. I'm going to use that to put a little bit in my inner corner extra. You could also take your highlight. This is, by the way, a fantastic highlighter shade as well. Like so, that's it. That is the eye look so far. I'm going to finish off the rest, eyeliner, falsies, lipstick, that kind of thing. And then I will be back and we can finish off the video. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. So here is the finished look with everything on. I like how it turned out. It is darker, but I kind of like it. For falsies, I ended up choosing the style 012 from AliExpress. They are a little bit more open, a little bit more spiky. I like them. And for lipstick, it's just a very pale lip gloss, basically. It's one from Primark, a high shine lip gloss. It came in a kit. It's one of those Kylie kit dupes, you know, with a lip gloss and a pencil. This is the color. The color name is, I don't know. I have no idea what the color name is, but yeah, it's just a pale pink lip gloss, basically. And the eyeliner that I have been using throughout all five looks is this one. It's a gel eyeliner pot from Maybelline. And I kind of feel that the looks that I did warranted a little bit more messy eyeliner. And it brought me actually back to the days before gel eyeliner, where we just, well, basically used an eye pencil to put black around our eyeballs. So yeah, this was the last look. Let me know down below which one was your favorite. I don't know if I have a favorite, to be honest. I actually like all the looks. They all have something different. They all have something unique. And what I liked most actually was that they were just, you know, quite basic, fast looks. So yeah, more complicated looks I will do probably with a palette bingo or something like that. Let me know if that is of interest to you. For now, I'm going to sign off. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, fabulous evening. And I will see you soon in my next one. Bye, guys.